Welcome to this presentation on simplifying decision tables. Only limited entry decision tables can be simplified, and usually in conjunction with a completeness check. You will see in this video how we will take a complex set of rules and express them as a decision table, and then simplify the table using a logical process so that it is much easier to read and maintain. Let us look at an example that shows how a set of complex rules can be expressed as a decision table and then simplified using a rigorous logical process. The end result is much easier to read and maintain. This limited entry decision table is to decide whether to accept or reject a customer's order. There are three conditions. Has the customer's credit limit been exceeded? Are they a prompt payer? Do they have special clearance? The associated action, depending on the combination of the conditions, is to either accept the order or to reject it. This is our simplifying rule. Any two rules which have identical entries except for one condition row, which contains a Y and N, may be consolidated into one rule which contains a dash, in place of the Y and N. Obviously, the rules must have the same action. So in the example, we can simplify rules 7 and 8. They have the same action and differ only by a Y and N in the third condition. So the resulting consolidated rule will become NN-X-. Rules 5 and 6 can be simplified to the rule NY-X-. However, rules 1 and 2 can't be simplified because they have a different action. But rules 1 and 3 can be to give Y-Y-X-. And finally, rules 2 and 4 can be consolidated to give the rule Y-N-X. So the resulting table will have four rules. This table can be simplified further. If we look at rules 3 and 4, we see they are identical except for the second condition. Is the customer a prompt payer? By simplifying these two rules, the resulting table will just have three. A third rule, N-X-. This table can't be simplified any further using the simplifying rules. However, we can see that condition test 2, is the customer a prompt payer, is no longer relevant and can be removed. One final thing we can do is to keep rule 2 and replace rules 1 and 3 with an else rule. In simplifying the decision table, we have logically reduced the 8 rule table to one rule and the else rule. The resulting decision table is to only reject the order where the customer has exceeded their credit limit and they don't have special clearance. Otherwise, we will accept it. I hope you found this video useful. More videos like this are available at rapidgen.com/videos. Please let us know if you have any questions about simplifying decision tables, or if we can help. Send us an email at info@rapidgen.com or use the options below to leave a message. Thank you for watching.